Who are you? And how can we know who you are? When you log on to your device, you have an identity.
But did you know that your device has an identity as well?
I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy.
Your devices can be in one of four states. And the reason for doing this video is to help you understand all of them. So when things like Windows Virtual Desktop support all of these device states, you'll be ready to make that transition. And the nice thing about that is you may not even need a domain controller anymore. Now, the big distinguishing factor between these four types really comes down to who owns the device and who controls the device. First one you're very familiar with, this is Active Directory Joined. We've been doing this for over 30 years. Everything is controlled through Active Directory. We have group policy management, device management, through things like Configuration Manager, Windows Update, and plenty of other on-prem and traditional tools. But now we can integrate things with Azure Active Directory. And that starts with Azure AD Registered. Get it? Register. So Azure AD Registered is where the machine is a bring your own device machine, but we can have some level of corporate policies apply through Azure AD, as well as if you're using an MDM or mobile device management solution like Intune or Microsoft Endpoint Manager. We'll do a video on that pretty soon. And those will give you the ability to have more controls over that device, even though the corporation doesn't own it. Now, the next scenario is Azure AD Hybrid Joined. This is where the machine is traditionally joined to Active Directory, but is registered in a more holistic kind of way to Azure Active Directory. This is where you can still have all those group policy and traditional device management controls combined with the power of the cloud and what we can push out from there and other MDM solutions. So, real powerful choice. But the one that I think is very future looking is Azure AD Joined. We no longer need that traditional domain controller. See ya. And now, because we don't need that domain controller anymore, we're saving a bunch of money. It's just Azure Active Directory and your device. So let's take a quick minute and talk about some benefits that you're missing out on. For example, did you know that 70% of you are watching the Azure Academy without being subscribed? That means you're not aware of when all the videos are coming out, and you can't really ask me any questions or contribute to any topics in the future. So take the first step in mastering Azure today by clicking that subscribe button and the notification bell. So what are the benefits of each of these scenarios? Azure AD Registered allows you to have single sign-on to your cloud-based resources. You can also have phone sign-in through your Microsoft Authenticator app. You get conditional access through your enrolling those devices in your MDM solution. That would be Intune and Microsoft Endpoint Manager. And remember, this is a bring your own device kind of scenario. So they get on the computer with a local account and then sign in additionally in the settings menu. We'll show you that in a minute, so that they can get access to those corporate resources. In the hybrid join scenario, we get a bit more. This is a corporate-owned device scenario, and we're gonna need our old friend Azure AD Connect in order to get this guy up and running. More about that in a minute. Remember, you still have all of that on-prem traditional stuff, but now you can have single sign-on to those cloud-based or on-prem resources and self-service password reset, which we just did a video on, so you can go check that out. You also get access to the Windows Hello features, and you can also have enterprise state roaming across your different devices. Finally, the Azure AD joined scenario, where you get access to that seamless single sign-on for on-prem and cloud resources, as well as self-service password reset, Windows Hello, enterprise state roaming, and conditional access with your MDM compliance. So let's get this all up and running.
If you want to master the Azure cloud, you can start right now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
All right, let's get into this thing. We're in Azure Active Directory, and we're going to go on the left over to our devices. And inside devices, you can see we don't have anything just yet. But let's take a quick second and talk about our device settings. Now, this really has to do with who can enable a device to be joined to your Azure AD. By default, it's all people. And then you can even limit the number of devices that everyone can have. 20 is the recommended number, but you can go up or down, whatever suits your purpose. So we've got three scenarios. So let's take the first one, which is Azure AD Registered. This is a basic Windows 10 VM that is not currently joined to a domain at all, just basically an out-of-the-box system. And here is my command prompt where I'm going to run a dsreg command. And in there, you can see this is the default state of Windows 10, not joined to anything. And if we go over to our web browser and we try to log into the Azure portal, it's going to prompt us for credentials because it doesn't have any idea who we are. So on the local system, we'll open the settings panel, go into accounts, and then on the left, we want to go to access work or school, then click connect. We'll put in our credentials, and when you sign in, if you have MFA enabled for your user account, you'll be challenged for that as I am. And then your device will become registered, which means the device is still yours, but now you are enabled to use workplace stuff. So back in our command prompt, you can see that we are workplace joined, that's registered, and you can see we've got our tenant information. So we'll do a little warp speed back to the Azure portal, and go back to our devices, and now we have an Azure AD registered system. One down, two to go. This is our hybrid joined VM. It is joined to our existing Active Directory. Back in the dsreg command, it only shows that it is joined to our domain, nothing related to Azure AD yet. Our SSO state is reporting as no, and our diagnostic data tells us that we've got a connectivity pass, but everything else is failing because we need to do some things to set this up. Back in our domain controller, you can see my machine in the computer's container, and that's going to become important in a second because I'm not syncing that. But let's take a quick look at our group policy. Over here, I've got an SSO group policy in which I am enabling four different URLs that you have to add to your trusted sites in order for this whole process to work. And then back in Azure AD Connect, we'll take a look at our synchronization options. I'll add my credentials and we'll skip past the first screen. And here on the second screen for our domain and OU filtering, I am not syncing my entire domain structure. You can see the computer's container is not checked, but the corp container is, and everything under that is being synced into Azure. So let's go back and now we'll change our device options. Click next. And then you'll see that you can add hybrid Azure AD join, which is exactly what we want. Let's hit next, add your credentials. And then the first option that's selected already is to configure hybrid Azure AD join. Click next. And now you have the choice of device type. Windows 10 and newer would be the top one. That's what I'll choose. If you have older devices, you may want to select both. Although you should be using everything Windows 10 and newer to keep your security vulnerabilities low. Let's hit next. Now we need to add a service connection point. This is what's going to do the magic. So I'll check my domain, then I'll hit the dropdown for Azure AD and then click add. This is where you need enterprise admin credentials, which I'll put in there and then click next, click configure and then hit exit. So that was easy. Let's open Azure AD's Connect synchronization tool. And at the top, it should be in operations by default, but we want to go to the metaverse search. I've got no clauses whatsoever, and I'll change my search type to device. Then over here, I'll click search, and you can see all of the different devices that it is aware of. Back in Active Directory, I'll take my computer object from the computer's container and drag it into the Azure Computers OU underneath Corps. That way it will be syncing and getting my policy. Then back in Azure AD Connect, we'll go back to operations and we want to right click and we want to do a Delta import. Okay, and that's going to find our object and then do a Delta synchronization in the same way. And that way we'll send that object off to Azure, which we can find back in the metaverse search. And there it is. That device is now being written to Azure AD. So when we go back to the machine and do our dsreg command, we can see everything is now passing. So we're good to go. This should be auto-registered. It just takes a reboot. And now there's all of our device details as well as our tenant information, including our tenant name and ID. So we're good to go. We are not workplace joined, so this is different than being registered. However, we do get an SSO state now. So I can go back to the Azure portal and I am SSO'd right into Azure AD. We'll go back to devices and there you can see our hybrid joined machine is now here. Final one of the day is Azure AD joined. just as before with the registered, we're starting off with a vanilla machine, not joined to a domain at all. Open the settings app, go back to your account, click on access work or school, click connect, but this time at the bottom, we're gonna click on join this device to Azure Active Directory. Go through your sign-in process, MFA if you have to, and then it will ask you, are you sure this is the organization you wanna join? If so, click the join button, it'll go through the process, and then you are all set. And you can see the briefcase icon now indicating that this is Azure AD Join. We're gonna reboot and then log back in with the creds that we just registered with. Go ahead and open your command prompt to dsreg, and then you will see that we are now Azure AD joined, and you can also see your device details as well as your tenant information. You'll have a user state because now you're actively logged in with a user on a registered device, and your SSO is ready. And we'll try to log on to the Azure portal again. SSO works. Back in Azure AD, go back to your devices, and we've got our Azure AD joined device. Three different device states that you can have as your device identity in Azure. Very easy to set up no matter which scenario you need. And this is the gateway into those MDM solutions like Intune, Microsoft Endpoint Configuration Manager, which we'll have a video about real soon. And now you're in a position so that when Windows Virtual Desktop and other features down the road support all these different joined states, then you'll be ready to implement them in your environment. Subscribe, notification bell, comment, click all the buttons and do all the things. And if you want to learn more about Azure Active Directory, over here on the bottom, we've got our Azure AD playlist. There's our latest video at the Azure Academy. Have a good week. Next week, same bat time, same bat channel. Happy learning.